Is this how big a blue whale is? Nope, bigger. How about this? Nope, even bigger. There we go. Did you know that hidden beneath the surface, our oceans are home to some of the most gigantic creatures on the planet? Yes, we're talking about whales. Of course, not all whales are as huge as these magnificent blue giants, but together, the family of whales are like the superheroes of the sea, with amazing abilities and lifestyles. From massive blue whales to small, playful dolphins, each whale has its own unique story. Grab your flippers and let's go. Want a souvenir of our journey? Check out our fact-filled activity sheets for sale now in the Socratica Foundation store. Find the links below. Before we think about all the differences between the different kinds of whales, let's remember what they all have in common. They're all mammals, like us. That's right. Although whales live in the ocean, they can breathe air just like us. And they have live babies who need care, just like our babies. Except these babies are quite a bit bigger, and they already know how to swim. Let's zoom in on the blue whale, the largest animal to have ever lived on our planet. Yes, even bigger than the largest dinosaurs. Blue whales can grow up to 30 meters long, which is almost as long as 3 school buses. And they can weigh as much as 200 tons. That's about the weight of 30 large elephants. Even though they are really big, blue whales are gentle giants, feeding mostly on tiny shrimp-like creatures called krill. A single adult blue whale can eat up to 6 tons of krill a day during feeding season. That's a huge dinner. Blue whales also sing, but their songs are often too low for humans to hear. These songs are believed to be used for communication and possibly even for navigating across the oceans. Blue whales are found in all of the world's oceans except the Arctic. They seem to feel the most at home in deep, open waters. Next, let's dive into the world of the gray whale, a true ocean wanderer. Gray whales are known for their impressive migrations, traveling up to 12,000 miles round trip, which is one of the longest migrations of any mammal on Earth. Migration is when animals move from one habitat to another during different seasons of the year. You've heard of birds flying south for the winter, right? We could say the same for the gray whales. They make the journey from the chilly Arctic waters where they feast on small crustaceans in the summer to the warm lagoons of Mexico where they breed and give birth in the winter. Gray whales are easily recognized by their speckled gray skin, covered with white spots. Unlike other whales, they don't have a dorsal fin. Instead, they have lots of bumps along their back. A dorsal fin is the fin on the back of a fish or whale that looks a little bit like a sail on a boat. The gray whale used to be called devilfish by early whalers because of their protectiveness over their calves and their fierce behavior when being hunted. Today, they're known to be quite curious and often approach whale watching boats. As they swim along the coast, gray whales play an important role in their ecosystem, stirring up the ocean floors and helping to maintain a healthy ocean environment. Thanks, big friends! Have you ever heard of a humpback whale? These whales are very large, growing up to 16 meters long, but they're incredibly graceful swimmers. They have long, wing-like pectoral fins. Pectoral fins are fins behind an animal's head that help them balance and navigate. Keep in mind, these aren't like the delicate fins on a fish. They're actually the whale's front limbs, like our arms. Humpback pectoral fins can be up to a third of their body length. Humpback whales are famous for their spectacular jumping displays, like breaching. Breaching is when they leap out of the water, creating a big splash that can be seen for miles. They're also known for their unique singing. Male humpbacks make sounds that can last half an hour, which scientists believe are used to attract mates. Humpbacks have strong social bonds and playful behavior, making them a favorite among whale watchers. Now it's time to talk about the famous orca. Also known as the killer whale, these mammals have a reputation for being a top predator of the sea. Did you know that orcas are whales and dolphins? Fun fact, all dolphins are whales, but not all whales are dolphins. This is because of the different ways we categorize marine mammals. By the way, If you want to dive deeper into dolphins, we have a whole video about them. Find the link in the description. But this video is for the big whales. So let's talk more about big, beautiful orcas. Orcas are easily recognizable by their striking black and white coloring and tall dorsal fins. Orcas' dorsal fins can get up to 2 meters tall in males. That's the size of a tall human. Wow. These intelligent and social creatures live in close-knit family groups known as pods. These pods are led by females, and they communicate with a wide variety of sounds. Each pod even has its own unique set of calls. Orcas are very good hunters. They will swim around, forcing fish into tight balls or create waves to push seals off the ice. Their impressive smarts, social groups, and hunting skills make orcas one of the most fascinating species in the marine world. Maybe that's why they're the stars of so many movies. Sperm whales are the largest whales with teeth and hold the record for having the biggest brain of any creature known to have lived on Earth. Their brain can weigh an astonishing 20 pounds. You can easily recognize these whales by their massive heads. Sperm whales are very good divers, diving down to depths of over 2,000 meters and holding their breath for up to 2 hours. They live in pods of 15 to 20 individuals and are known for their strong social bonds, especially between mothers and their calves. The clicking sounds they make, which are the loudest of any animal, are not just for communication, but also echolocation. Echolocation is when animals use sound waves to swim and find food in the pitch black depths of the sea. Sperm whales were also the inspiration for the classic novel Moby Dick. These whales continue to fascinate us with their deep sea life. Up next, we have a whale that can be found in the chilly waters of the Arctic, the beluga whale. These whales are often called the canary of the sea because they make lots of different vocal sounds like clicks, whistles, and clangs. Belugas are easily recognizable by their unique rounded foreheads. Belugas are pretty small compared to other whales, reaching about 4 meters in length. They start out dark gray as calves, but get lighter as they age. You know a beluga is all grown up when it turns completely white. Want to remember the special colors and patterns of whales? Get out your colored pencils and markers and capture different whales in our coloring pages. Follow the links below for our activity pages that keep the smart fun going after the video. But we're not finished yet. We have more to learn about those shimmery white belugas. Beluga whales live in pods that usually range from 10 to 25 individuals. These pods are extremely important for their survival in icy habitats. The pod works together to be more successful hunters. Beluga whales are also very playful with each other, chasing each other and making toys out of the things they find in the water. They've even been seen spitting water at each other or even human observers. You've probably heard of unicorns, but have you heard of the unicorn of the sea? That's right. Narwhals are known as the unicorns of the ocean because of their long spiraled tusk. But what a lot of people don't know is that this tusk is actually a very large tooth that can grow to over 2.5 meters long. This tooth serves several purposes, like feeling for changes in the water and possibly attracting mates. The narwhal is a medium-sized whale that mainly lives in Arctic waters. Like many deep-sea dwellers, they rely on sound to communicate and make their way through dark waters beneath the ice. Unlike many marine species that migrate across oceans, narwhals can't live in very many places because they must stay in Arctic cold waters. They swim from deep waters in the winter to shallower waters and bays in the summer. This makes them more sensitive to climate change and melting ice. Let's look out for our unicorn friends and protect these habitats. There's no such thing as a wrong whale, but there definitely is a right whale. Right whales can grow up to 16 meters long. These massive creatures were once called the right whale to catch because they were easy for whalers to hunt. But now they are protected, and people are no longer allowed to hunt them. Right whales live on the coast and are often seen close to the shore. Do you know how people get calluses on their hands from hard work? Right whales have something called callosities, which are thick patches of skin on their heads. These callosities are like the right whale's own natural fingerprint, making it possible for scientists and researchers to tell each whale apart from the others. Last but certainly not least, we have the pygmy whale. Also known as the pygmy right whale, this little guy is the smallest of the baleen whales. Baleen whales are a group of whales that eat using a strategy called filter feeding. Baleen whales filter feed with a unique strainer in their mouths called a baleen that allows them to filter out water from their food. Pygmy whales are a rare sight, spending most of their time in the deep, cold waters of the Southern Ocean, away from where humans can see them. So not a ton is known about these whales. We do know that these whales have unique bones in their ears, making them quite the underwater listeners. And they feed on small fish and squid, quietly gliding through the ocean's depths. The pygmy whale reminds us that there are still so many mysteries in the ocean waiting to be discovered. Have you ever seen a whale in person? Would you like to? If you could ask a whale one question, what would it be? What do you think whales would like to ask us? Each of these incredible whales plays an important role in the ocean's ecosystem. As we continue to explore and learn about these magnificent beings, remember, we can make smart choices to look out for the well-being of all creatures, great and small. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our coloring pages and activity sheets made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.